turn to pick.
Magnus, Ember. Okay.
I kind of like this. I think they needed somebody that could also play fast while the void is still ramping up.
What? Oh, he's not going to make it there in time. Oh, wasted rotation. No.
Oh, Supreme. Two
but wait,
one.
But wait.
Okay, slight dodge doesn't work, and first blood.
It was better. It wasn't even wasted. It worked out.
Benji lives. Mid lane. Making a play onto Supreme. Great stun from Hanskin. Misses the disjoint again with the slight.
Brutal.
And now Crit gonna try to TP out. Close one. Does make it.
Dire structures are fortified.
Yeah, that was a little bit.
Yeah. I know, look at this. Do they scout him out?
He's gonna get right cleaved by? And died.
Oh, they found him. That would have been such a big brain play if he just sat in this little spot behind the trees and just leeched all that XP.
I mean, it's still four heroes. It's not like he's getting half of it or something.
Yeah, you're right. Up top, Eric gonna die.
Perfect.
All right, hey, put down this. Honestly, this ancient stack might be more important.
Maybe okay, never mind. Maybe that's why FNG was here. I wasn't even thinking about that.
We have full fight here. Crit in trouble. He's going to be locked down, just tanking the Chakram, accepting his fate.
All right, so FNG's going to want to just keep farming stacks, so I think they're just going to have to give up one of these tier 2 towers. They're actually going at Nico maybe a bit here. Wow, they are peed.
Oh, they're going to find him. Clone?
Oh, no.
Oh, my gosh. He was like 1 HP. Now he drops the Chrono the other way. DP does get off a Spirit Siphon. I don't know if they'll be able to find any counter kills here. Charlie with the TP. Wow, that was greedy. Now swap coming in. They're going to find Crit as well. Another swap.
Sandalite
loses his TP. They're going to get three out of this. The Chrono helps set it up. The Void not only lives, but they turn it back to kill three the other way. A lion.
If we do some quick theoretical math here, if you were to buy an early Agnes, well, Crit's going to probably die here from the fuel.
I would imagine so.
So if a Timbersaw bought an Aghanim's early and kept his ulti level 1, it would cost...
Is he the only hero that you can just double his ultimate and get away with it? Not being completely broken?
It's just kind of neat because you have to like place both and it takes a lot of mana.
This is what you mentioned, the Atos against Lina before she has Yules.
That was well before there was going to be any Will-O-Wisps to help.
Midas into SNY on Void. Oh, here we go. Supreme initiated on the target of choice. The Will-O-Wisp comes down. RP onto two. It's a pretty good setup. The Laguna Blade. Can they actually find these kills, though? Ignis almost done. S4 does go down alongside Hanskin, but now Limp charging into the back line. NIP low on cooldowns. Saberlight maybe gets left behind. He'll be the first to fall on NIP. Now Chrono on two. Does click that Ember. Era should go down. He does. Supreme trying to make it to the high ground. How far do they go? Nico baby rooted up. They will back and try to finish off this tier 2.
Why did they stay low ground?
I don't know.
I have no explanation.
It's a 2-for-2, but it is going to favor Alliance. They get the tower out of it. That's the case. That happens.
Yeah, at least it was only one more hero. They didn't like lose two or something. So it wasn't too big of a deal.
Wop, trying to buy himself some time.
Oh, he just got that courier.
Yo, that was a 5-1.
That was sick.
And he's still...
middle tower is under attack.
Hanskin gamers, the glove, baby. Give him the glove. That's four. Now he's going to get caught. It's a 1-on-4 scenario. He lives.
Oh, the soul rip.
He even gets Laguna and still survives. Meanwhile, Era dies off to the side to limp. And
Charlie, no.
In a little bit too deep. No target to jump to. Takes a bash and he's down. Visual Blitz Knuckles now as part of the MKB buildup. Even without the PA on heroes like this, the MKB feels pretty good. They had a Sentry Ward down, and they're going to drop the Chrono to find this kill onto Supreme. Is it actually going to be a kill, though? They need a little more. Slight.
They have a Remnant down.
Try to make it away. He does have fast Remnants, though.
Wow.
Supreme actually lives. No! Bad! See you later. Yeah, it was comical.
Considering he didn't have a Remnant down, and he still almost lived, that was a little bit crazy.
Find something here. Hanskin bumps into Charlie. Hanskin's going to be in trouble. Does get off a stun, a swap. Meanwhile, up top, Crit going blow for blow with S4. Crypt Swarm finishes him off. 1-for-1 there. Now Saberlight looking for the TP. That's a Yules.
I was giving me a little RP fake out.
We can force something here.
It's like pretty even. Yeah, Void living there was just...
It was still like a 6k lead at that point or something brutal. It was a little bit of a Hail Mary play to start with, and they flubbed it.
I guess so. Fair enough. Here we go. Smoke up. Alliance looking for something here. Chrono available. Catches two. Blinding Light, though. It's there. No MKB yet. They'll still get the kill onto Crypt, but they pay for it with Hanskin. Saberlight silenced up, destroyed by the Chakram.
Power. She's got a Deso. She's got the 10-second BKB. So she's looking for the game winner. FNG.
Limp has got an Eon Disc queued up. He is ready to respect the potential burst damage of NIP, even 15k net worth behind. Here comes the initiation. FNG does get dropped. BKB by the PA gets bashed. Just right click down. Ignis almost saves her, and it does. RP from Saberlight, but they need a little bit more. There's just no follow-up damage. Crit goes down. Charlie up on the high ground will live.
Baby.
Saberlight, TP, not gonna happen. Atos is there. No buybacks available on the two dead heroes of the Dire. Nico low, time walk forward. Once Charlie might find it,
Aegis is gonna expire.
Yules, they get one more. They've found her, the Coddle, and it's gonna be a clean sweep. That's five dead for just a position five.
We're gonna make it back.
Yeah, I agree. This is the kind of Ember pick that I like. You're picking it with a purpose in a specific lane matchup. You're not just doing cookie cutter builds. No, you're buying items that let you enable plays like this where Era's going to get caught. S4 can still play this tanky front.
What are our thoughts on Undying? I mean, he won the game. Was he a huge part of it? I don't really remember any big tombstones.
I would rephrase that to say his team won the game.
Hey, he gave Nuka maybe a free lane with a Midas.
Yes.
And he had the big save earlier on S4 with the Soul Rip.
The Undying was fine. There is part of me that feels like he could have been any support that has some sustain, like an Oracle or some sort of comparable. And this game would have looked pretty similar, but damage from the very first creep kill. And that's something Ogre can't give you. So I'm with it. I'm slowly getting more and more sold on this hero is completely viable.
I do think he's probably still trashing your pubs, guys. I'm just going to be real. I don't think you should pick Undying. Unless you're like Immortal, then you can play Undying.
But I think
if you guys are lower than Immortal,
three.
Just, you know.
I can tell you that for sure. Three Undying is not a thing. I've given up trying to make fetch happen, Trent.
Yeah. Dying's middle barracks. I mean, if you're playing him in lower tiers, just buy items, though. Don't try and be FNG. Buy big.
They'll smoke. Checking for Roche. Ooh, nice positioning from FNG. They jump onto S4. Not the target that they want, though. They do stop the Timber Chain. Support inbound, though. Alliance is here. They'll catch Era.
Oh, that's a bad Will-O-Wisp, though. Now you can just chrono up on the high ground. Wait, look at two.
Still, it's a decent chrono. Does catch the Magnus. Crit dies off to the side. It's going to be three down on NIP.
He only gets two. That's how you know they're winning really hard.
Yep. And now Supreme on the retreat. He's going to try to Remnant out, but Hanskin was ready and waiting at the low ground. Mine queued up. Only 3,800 gold to go.
He's okay. Crit, just hold on, buddy. You're a pro player, right? You're on that big team. You can 1v5 them.
Go, baby. Skewered. Time walk solves that problem. Nico Bay.
Dire's top tower.
A little sad here for NIP, just watching their base die. No chrono, still down for 80.
Dire's top barracks are under attack.
It's just a hard game when you had one aggressive maneuver the entire match and you didn't finish off the Void, and then you were just on the back foot the whole time.
Yeah. It's, in some ways, it feels like a shame when a match is almost decided by one bad engagement like that.
Balance.
I think that's the best answer you could have come up with there. Oh, the Observer comes
down. If it was 17, it would be for memes.
Yeah, there you go. PA jumps in. Ooh, BKB.
Oh, the Halberd, though.
Disarmed, swapped back. It's a decent Ignis, but Charlie still just trying to live. Another Phantom Strike back. Not the way you want that 9-second BKB to go. Now the Chrono comes down. PA dead. Saberlight also in trouble. GG's call. That'll do it. 33-8.
Now this looks like some NA Dota.
Yeah, this was one of those never really a moment when it looked like NIP had it. Or even really had a big window, as you said.
Turn to
I guess it's going to depend, because it's either going to be Magnus or Prophet mid, depending on what alliance take, right?
Yeah.
Because they probably want to put Nature's Prophet with the Earth Shift. Falling off a little bit. He's actually only like 8%, so not as high as I thought. But his win rate's still really high. It's like 53%. So he's one of the higher win rates in Immortal right now.
Era maybe in trouble here. S4 did go Poison Sting level 1 and finally gets it off. Now Era slowed down a little more for this first blood. They will find it. Limp chops down some trees, takes a lot of tower shots.
Kicker player, because not only do you have like whole game synergy together with like global stuff and like ganks, but he just gives you so much space in lane that even though you're kind of a bad laner, it works out. And Supreme getting low. It's cool though.
Up top, Nico baby getting low. Oh, he's stuck in the trees. That was beautiful. Saberlight surrounded him with the Nature's Call treants, and he had nowhere to go. Saberlight now going to try to TP. Close, but does make it.
Wow. Those treants have a lot of time left, too. FNG is going to take a lot of damage.
Might still live here.
There's a Fisher. Oh, no. Wrong side.
Need one more. Pops the salve. Knocks it off, but FNG does live.
And he's into the south.
Left Nico fine up top.
May your saplings grow strong with the gifts of the
He's got
earth.
Blocked out there, but he'll be good. To the jungle we go. It looks like you were right about this mid matchup. Timber's having a grand old time.
Seems like fun. Jungle time for the mag and whatnot. Try and pressure a little bit here.
Top lane, FNG. It's a nice nightmare, but just buys him a couple of seconds.
Man, he almost found a way out there. Just too many trees, though.
Dude, Saber crit is going to get that double damage rune, but that is another aspect of it. When your mid laner is just jungling to recover, he does have a double stack here. That's something. But that means Limp should be able to get a lot of rune control. Leeches some of this XP. Only level 5. If he had Chakram here, I think Supreme's dead 100%. Does not have enough mana for Skewer. Nico Baby does die, but so does Supreme. He walks next to a tree and just gets whirlinged to death.
He literally just bought his boots and walked him down. That sucks.
So, I was watching that, though. I saw our observer caught that Slark kill up top. Well done.
Dire's top tower.
And Era also going to take a tumble. Action all over the place.
They try to get aggressive.
S4 low, going to stand his ground. Man up against Charlie. The high five coming out. Stick charges. It's going to be close, but Charlie stunned. Beautifully done by Hanskin. And meanwhile, up top. Looking for Saberlight here. They missed the Chakram. TP out. There is a pounce. They found it. But now they need the damage. Saberlight can just do it again. And he will. All right, another great teleport.
Tough spot, though. And there goes his courier.
Travel faster.
Potential setup onto the Rick.
Under attack.
Hanskin misses the roll, though. Now TP bottom from crit. Gonna have a go onto S4. Some follow-up, perhaps. Grimstroke buffs up crit. That'll be the kill onto S4 that they came for. Pretty nice.
Oh, nice.
Charlie looking to TP and makes it. Crit intercepts the roll. But now Era, he's going to be left behind. They still got a couple of these Plague Wards to help out. And it will be a one-for-one support. Stock standard. Look at what's FNG doing here. He got some double stacks going. He got two triple stack camps. Well, that's nice.
Radiant's bottom tower.
Some of the best top team at farming them.
Crit and Saberlight going to be in some trouble. Wrap around from Limp. The carrier has arrived, and they will explode Saberlight. And they'll surround Crit as well. He is level 6, has the dunk, but Crit knows that there's no turn play here, and he's just going to run for it. We'll save the big cooldown.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
God.
Bottom lane, pressure on the tier 1 tower. EP coming in from the Prophet. They found him. Was trying to be sneaky in the trees, but they seem to have sniffed it out. Magnetize. Big reaction from NIP. They're going to get Hanskin. Four heroes down here in the bottom lane. Quality thing without that first item. And it's just hard. You have to weather the storm. Charlie jumps in on the Bane. Yeah, he gets the Inkswell. That'll be a first kill. Very nice.
They don't.
Leading with Charlie.
Oh, there's their hero.
They can kill Nico here. This will be huge. He's going to go into this big stack. Perfect timing. Gets off the ult, though. The dunk.
I mean, that could not have gotten any better.
Yep, they cleared out the stack, too. That was pretty perfect. But now the punishment. Crit, he's going to be in trouble, and they've got the setup onto Era. Crit will fall first. Now the turn onto the other support. And, okay. Could have gone a little better.
As they have the grip, so they're looking for their own big carry target. They're going to find Supreme. I don't think they have the damage. Oh, with Magnetize.
Find out. Both ults, Magnetize, Fiend's Grip, Limp is coming in. I think with Limp, they've got this pretty easy. And yeah, they do.
Yeah, Limp and S4 just slowly closing out. I mean, they have Soul. Man, Slark has boring level 10 talents. 9 strength or 6 agi. Wow.
Wowzers.
How exciting.
Mid lane, FNG. Nice setup there. Era gonna grab it with the stroke. They want the punishment though. Charlie trying to make it out, but silence. TP. Yule's now there just in time. Now trying to jump forward. They do put the Inkswell onto him. Still a lot of damage coming his way, and Charlie will not survive. Era with a bold TP. That won't work either.
I thought you're gone.
That's another good voice line. Crit now, wandering his way down bottom. No ulti, set up by Limp. This Shaker might find himself in a world of hurt.
Oh, nice roll.
Didn't think he was going to get him there.
Knocking back in, and another layup for Limp. Saber feels less like a sunk cost item. It actually builds into something, so that's good.
Yeah, I still see Defusal sometimes, and I also still see Midas, too. Like some people are trying that. Halberd, you disassemble for the Ogre Axe, and then back into like an Orchid or something.
Oh, wow, that's efficient.
Well, get real crazy. Limp. They don't need crazy. They need this kill is what they need, and they got him.
And they get him. Very nice. Prophet coming in, looking for more. S4 may be low, but now Nico Baby's here. Fissure breaks things up a little bit. Nico Baby in pretty deep. Very much committed to this kill. Does have the ulti. Drops it and gets the reset. Shaker already used the dunk. Supreme also in trouble. This Magnetize doing a lot of work. And NIP getting close to cleaned up here. Charlie isolated now. Not going to be able to find these kills. Inkswell not going to do it for him either. It's a 1-for-4. Soon to be 5. Era. Dunzo. Well, what?
There's moments where you're just like,
looks like.
Yeah, but at least it's giving them space, right? Like, you shouldn't even be getting a trade right now against a lot of lineups if they had, like, any, like, really good power pusher.
Well, they'll find Supreme in the mid lane, set up from Hanskin, and he gets evaporated. Scary that they were able to kill him that quickly.
Yeah, the Veil. Seeing this a lot on the Earth Spirits as well.
Yeah, great item. Now Era, he's going to get rolled on. Charlie drops the silence, trying to do what
he can.
NIP starting to turn this. They will kill Hanskin. Limp in the front line. Nico Baby here. He gets silenced straight away, but does still kill Saberlight. Era on the run. NIP in full retreat now. There's only 3 left. Make it 2. Poison Nova now connects. This Ricky going to be in a world of hurt. Tricks of the trade. Looking for the target onto Crit. Then Crit blinks away. And now Charlie's got no options. They don't have any detection, but he is going to die from the dots, it looks like.
Oh, wait, now one.
Stick.
I think he's good.
He's good. He's good.
They
ran out of detection.
I thought it was good that Crit also didn't use the dunk on the 2 heroes. Like, because he knew they were going to get the 1 kill, and the dunk was kind of pointless, and he has Blink that he wants to flex it with.
RP. Big RP. This could be the beginning of a turn. FNG, Hanskin both dead. The follow-up dunk. They get Nico. Crit does end up going down. S4 here by himself without an ult.
He Midas the small bird in a panic.
Well, it happens. Okay, well, what was that about an RP setup?
They got it. And then again, Crit holding that echo, right? That was nice too.
He's also somewhat mobile.
It is weird that they have 0 auras though. The only aura they have is Veil. So I guess they have 1 aura, but it's basically just passive.
Here we go. Set up in the top lane. Slark getting low. It looks pretty good for NIP, but they can't finish him off. Crit, on the other hand, he might be the target that goes down. And now the turn onto Ricky. Nico Baby still healthy, and it's... This isn't going to be the easiest gank. They're going to have to commit pretty deep into the jungle. Although Nico Baby, he's going to walk up. Uh-oh, he walks right into the danger zone. See you later, Nico Baby.
God, Crit is like stone cold, man. How do you not dunk there? I would just be so scared that he's going to somehow get out.
Saberlight has the BKB. Going to show it off here.
Come on and slam.
This could be a bad fight for Alliance. They'll drop the RP to get one. Now the dunk on the other side connects on two. Follow up Soulbind. Alliance in big trouble. S4, limp in deep. Buybacks coming though. Alliance now have five back on the board. They turn onto the Ricky. So far, these buybacks worth it. Let's see if they can get more. Supreme in big trouble. He's going to fall next. They do get two big core kills. Still very much in poverty mode. He's about on par net worth wise with this Ember or Limp Spirit. Yeah, he sure is. He has a lot of support inbound too. They'll find the Shaker off to the side. And now Limp is so tanky, he can just entertain this back line while the rest of his team tries to bring down Crit. They will. Supreme finds the kill on FNG. A one for one so far as Ricky tries to make it out. TP, not gonna happen. Soulbind, no follow-up there. BKB TP from Supreme. It's a full retreat.
You with the Vanguard too, right? The damage block.
Era doing a good job finding a path in the tree line. TP out. Yule Scepter. Free kill there from... There is a BKB on Magnus. And he'll just TP without using the BKB. Bane was there anyway with... Oh, Fiend's Grip was on cooldown. Now he's going to be forced to use the BKB. No skewer, and Fiend's Grip has cooled down. Oh, Supreme, that's a big-time bummer there.
Yeah, I get it, though.
I get it, too. It's like, you don't want to be greedy, but it's one of those, you died anyway, you used your BKB anyway. Just play it safe. Now they get Grimstroke, and no buyback on the Magnus, either. So, they've got the big ults, the dunk, the RP.
Yeah, but they're not coming back.
Remember, Aegis on Slark, though, and a 10-second BKB. So even if they dunk him, dare I say, so what? That one's from Ricky. He gets disarmed right away. There's the dunk. He gets silenced. No follow-up RP. Magnus holding the buyback. Crit will use his, though. Nico Baby moving in. Now all the buybacks come from NIP. Look on skin. No RP yet, though. Good Yule. Supreme struggling to get on a target. The back line. Charlie trying to jump on the Venno, but just doesn't have the damage. And now Supreme might die back. Has to BKB. RP's solo limp. They turn this kill, it could be huge. Limp getting very low. Slark coming in. Limp does go down. They're also going to get the Slark's Aegis.
Yeah, I think Nico maybe just needed to die before. He tried to reset, but they had too much vision, so he never got his HP back.
Yeah, he's got spider legs. Maybe he can get out. Kills the Embrace. Alliance looking for a retreat, but now Prophet's here.
Ricky as well. Hey, doing this?
They might get S4.
Radiance middle barracks.
Skewer him back up, and they will. Well, another one of these moments where it is advantageous for Alliance, but very messy. Three buybacks used, four buybacks used, so a costly hold for NIP, but they do stay in the game.
That.
Live, and I underestimated his survivability, or overestimated it, rather. Crit. He's going to be the target of choice. Fiend's Grip, that'll lock him down. Now NIP, they might be in too deep. BKB, TP from Saberlight. He makes it out, but Era not going to be so lucky. Charlie with a regular...
They do have the RP back now, though. And in combination with the Ricky, you can do something, but you're going to need the Grimstroke first.
Up to high ground we go. No buybacks on the two dead heroes. It's a good skewer. Does not RP at this time, and instead Saberlight getting dove. He'll be brought down. No buyback.
Yeah, he saw the HP from the Bloodstone and was like, yeah, that's not worth it. Very unlikely we kill him. So Soulbind's up.
I've got him. The
bottom barracks are under attack.
Potential final hold coming out of NIP pretty soon. They've got the dunk. They've got the RP. Now, do Alliance back up or do they?
Is Charlie's gonna get a courier? Maybe. Oh, maybe not. Oh, yeah.
Oh,
but they have the off-century combo. Oh, no.
And there's also a gem on Bane. So they are in good shape to punish this Ricky. And boy, do they. Charlie down. No bomb timber. Oh, it's Saberlight. And this time he does not have a BKB. Still on cooldown from that last.
I like that with the Gale. But he sends it off. He doesn't want it. Under attack. He knows it's too good on Timber.
Oh, okay. Yeah, he takes the Nether Shaw instead. Well, buyback sparse for the Radiant. They don't have any. So no second chances here. Ricky and Magnus both have theirs cooling down. Saberlight pops that BKB. This repair kit putting in work right now. It is slowing down the push. There's the glyph. Saberlight in trouble though. RP comes out, does connect on two, but where's the follow-up? Crit can't get in there for the dunk. The blink dagger keeps getting broken.
What a bash.
We're gonna spread out now, but Ricky in trouble. Supreme dies. Buyback is available there, but Ricky doesn't have it. Now Grimstroke falls, he pops that buyback immediately. The dunk doesn't do much, and GG does get called. Alliance do manage to close it out. Takes them 40 minutes, but they take another convincing win.